Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Some of you guys have asked me in the comments how I created this material that I use in one of my videos. So I decided to create this tutorial to show you step by step how to make it, and you'll see that it's actually quite easy. So this is the final result. It's really cool and all procedural, so you can easily customize it. By the way, if you have any suggestions for another Blender tutorial, just let me know in the comments of this video. Without any further ado, let's get started. Here we have a sphere to preview the material. I'm gonna use the Node Wrangler add-on in this tutorial. So if you don't have it enabled, you can just go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, search for Node, and enable Node Wrangler. With the sphere selected, I'm gonna go to the Shader Editor, add a new material, and rename it to Rusty Metal. Now I'm gonna press Shift-A and search for the Musgrave texture. I'm gonna hold Ctrl-Shift and select the node to preview the result. I'm also going to press Ctrl-T to add the texture coordinate and the mapping node. And now I'm going to plug object into vector. I'm using the object's coordinate because it's going to place the texture more evenly on the object. Now I'm going to change the Musgrave texture to multifractal. Change the scale to 1.2. Set the detail all the way up to 15. And I'm going to set the dimension to 0. Okay, so these dark areas are going to be the rust. And these white areas are going to be the metal. Now I'm going to add a color ramp to control the colors, so press Shift-A and search for a color ramp and drop it here. I'm going to plug the color into the base color of the principal BSDF, hold Ctrl-Shift and select the principal BSDF, and now I'm going to set the colors. So this one is going to be 7D, 39, 1C. I'm going to add a new slider to create some color variation. And this one is going to be 79. 4, 6, 1D. You don't need to use the same colors I'm using. You can just experiment and see which colors work better for you. For the metallic part, I'm going to use a gray, so it's going to be 717171. And I'm going to grab the slider and move it to something like here, I guess. So now we need to control the metallic of our material, but the rust part is not going to be metallic, so I'm going to use the Musgrave texture to determine where it's going to be metallic and where it's not going to be metallic. So I'm going to plug the height of the Musgrave texture into the metallic of the principal BSDF. Now I'm going to add another layer of rust. So I'm going to press Shift-A and search for a noise texture. Let's plug the object of the texture coordinate into the vector of the noise texture as well. I'm going to hold Ctrl-Shift and select the noise texture to preview it. I'm going to change the scale to 7. I'm going to set detail all the way up to 15. And I'm going to change the roughness to 0.65. Now let's bring in a color ramp and drop it here. And now I'm going to flip these two values. All right. Yeah, I think it looks good. Okay, so now I'm going to mix these two colors together. And to do this, I'm going to bring in a mix node. I'm going to change it to color. And I'm going to plug the result into the base color of the principal BSDF. And I'm going to plug this color into the factor of the mix node. And I'm going to plug this color into the A. And I'm going to use the B value to determine the color of the second layer of rust. Okay, so I'm going to set the color. So the hex value will be H3402C. Again, you don't need to use the same colors I'm using. It's just for reference. Okay, so now we need to work on the roughness. So what I want to do, I want to increase the roughness on the rusty areas and make it more shiny on the metallic areas. And to do that, I'm going to select this mix node and press Shift-D to make a copy of it. And I'm going to plug this color into the factor and this color into the B. Let me preview this result first. So the dark areas will be more shiny and the other areas will be more rough. So I'm going to plug the result into the roughness. Ctrl-Shift select the principal BSDF. So I'm going to use the A value to reduce the roughness because it's a bit too shiny. Okay, a bit more. Okay, so now we need to add some bumpiness. So I'm going to bring in a bump node. So Shift-A, search for a bump. Plug normal into normal. And I'm going to use this color to be the height. I'm going to select invert to invert the bumpiness. I'm going to reduce the strength. All right. So now I'm going to add a new layer of bumpiness. So select the bump node and press Shift D to duplicate it. Plug normal into normal. So now I'm going to use this color to be the height of the bump node. Okay, so now I'm going to disable the invert. Okay, so let me reduce the strength because I want it to be really subtle. Alright, yeah, I think it looks good. And that's it. This is the final result. As it's procedural, you can easily customize it. So for example, you can adjust the bumpiness like this. You can change this color to make it look like a really old metal. And you can also use the slider to increase the rust. You can use this one as well, like so. And that's it. So if you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. This way you're gonna make this content reach more people. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.